What's up, guys? If you're new, welcome. My name's Cal, and if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being a part of this community. If you're new to the channel, you will know that I'm an accounting student. And today I want to get right to it and explain to you why I think accounting is the best business degree that you can choose if you're interested in business or business school. We're also going to talk about why a general business degree is a bad idea and why you should avoid other business adjacent degrees like advertising and marketing. One thing before we get into the video, I am starting a weekly newsletter, and I'm going to share topics that are similar to the ones that we talk about on this channel. If you're interested at all, just drop your email down below. Click on the link and you can share your email with me and I will put you on the list. A titan of business once said that accounting is the language of business. You may be familiar with this quote, and you may be familiar with the man who said it. His name is Warren Buffett, and he's one of the richest people to ever live. Of all the business degrees that you could study and acquire, accounting gives you the tools, it gives you the skill set to understand business and the inner mechanics of all companies. I've heard it said that being an accountant is like being a doctor for business. You're able to diagnose and see the entire body of a business and see what's working, what isn't, if the company is healthy or not. An accounting degree allows you to analyze all of the financial statements, the cash flow statement, the balance sheet, the income statement, and from that you can deduce, is this company doing well or not? Oftentimes people will study accounting in undergrad and maybe they'll take a master's course in it as well, and then they'll go on to spend a few years in public accounting, which is kind of like a crash course that gives you all the basics and the hands-on experience working with companies, working with partnerships, working with LLCs and corporations to apply the knowledge that you learned in undergrad to real life. This linking of education to real world experience is so valuable. There are other degree paths that carry this same sort of experience. If you're a lawyer or a doctor, you're gonna have similar classroom experience that you then apply in the real world. But the incredible thing about accounting is that it's relatively quick and relatively cost effective to gain an accounting degree in relation to, you know, becoming a lawyer or becoming a doctor. If you are interested in business, this accounting education crash course in public accounting is unlike anything else. It allows you to see into the heart of the business, unlike any other degree. Marketing or advertising or general business, all of that's gonna be on the periphery of business. Accounting lives at the heart of it. There is no successful business that can run properly without accounting. Just think about that for a second. Another great benefit of accounting is that when you're studying the degree, you are gaining very specific knowledge that you can apply in the real world to a job after you graduate. In my opinion, this can't necessarily be said about marketing degrees or advertising degrees, and especially general business degrees. Accounting gives you that skill set, and then almost any company in the world requires your skill set. That's incredible. And if you want to become very specialized, you can take that public accounting path and become very specialized in a certain specialty. So you might focus on real estate, on the tax side, or you might become an auditor within automotive or some other industry. So not only do you gain that specific knowledge in your undergrad, after school, as you're working in your professional life and you're gaining this experience, you're gonna gain even more specific experience within a certain niche or field. I know other degrees can offer this too. Marketing, advertising, I know that these opportunities exist, but the plethora of opportunities that exist within accounting, I think, are far greater than some of these other opportunities in these other business degree paths. But for the sake of your career, I think it's very, very important that you have somewhat of an idea of your ability to learn and grow within the career. And one thing that brings me great comfort within accounting is knowing that throughout my undergrad, I was learning and progressing. As I move through my CPA exams now, I'm moving and progressing. As I move into my professional career, I'm still moving and progressing and becoming more specialized and therefore more valuable in a certain area. Even if you don't choose accounting, I would urge you to take a look at this for yourself in whatever career that you've chosen. Do you have the ability to continue to learn and continue to specialize as you move along? Another tremendous benefit of recruiting that goes along with what we were just talking about is this recruitment pipeline that comes from undergrad into public accounting firms and even into industry-based firms. Especially in large state schools and other smaller schools as well, public accounting firms come and recruit at these places directly. They recruit for their internship programs, and then from their internship programs, they move you into full-time positions. This is a very, very robust pipeline. The businesses of these public accounting firms are built on this concept that They will bring in that fresh blood, so to speak, and move those new people through the predetermined ranks of staff to in charge, onto manager and senior manager and all of the different levels. It's very systematic in the way that it works. And so they have a demand, they have a need for new hires. In this regard, the accessibility of accounting, if you want to work hard, is incredible. I really cannot overstate this enough. If you're someone who's interested in business, you want to work hard, and you want to make money, accounting can be an amazing place. On top of that, cherry on top, is that accounting allows you, in my opinion, to continually learn and improve yourself. And there are some incredible firms out there. Definitely look outside of the Big Four, even though a lot of the Big Four are really great places too. But there are some amazing places to work that will encourage your growth, and you'll work with great people on great teams, and I think that you will feel a sense of purpose as you work there. The risk to reward ratio when it comes to accounting is completely in your favor, in my opinion, and out of all the business degrees, offers the best value. The amount of time you spend in school, the amount of money you're gonna pay for your degree, the speed at which your income is going to increase, especially if you look for opportunities after 2 or 3 years in public accounting. There are just no other business degrees that really offer the same certainty or even opportunity as an accounting degree would. Finally, I want to tackle one trope of accountants that I'm sure you've heard before. A lot of people say that accountants are boring. Here's what I have to say about that. You go work a marketing job, you go work an advertising job, you go work a general business management job or any other field. You go work an entry-level sales job. All of those jobs are going to be incredibly boring and slow in the beginning. Now, they don't need to be. If you make it exciting, if you sink your teeth in, if you try to learn as much as possible, and if it truly is boring and horrible, I would urge you to look elsewhere. But people talk about accounting being boring as if other entry-level jobs aren't equally as boring. Any job when you start out is all about gaining the experience. You need to gain the knowledge to be valuable. Oftentimes this comes with many, many, many hours of rather mundane work, which is when you are accruing the essential knowledge that you need to become valuable for your firm, to become valuable for clients, and to become valuable inherently for yourself in order to add that value to others if you want to take that other places, to other industries, other businesses. That slow, boring work is when you really sink your teeth in and begin to enrich yourself with the knowledge you need to become the best you can be. As you put in that work, as you specialize, we were talking about that earlier, I think that your options begin to open up because you've gained more experience, you've gained more knowledge that you can then offer to other people. Let's put this very simply, when you are able to help other people, in my opinion, helping other people is not boring. And so sure, there may be some upfront time, like any other job, where you are just grinding it out day in, day out, in an accounting firm, getting it done. That's gonna be the same at any other place. So here's my advice when it comes to choosing your degree. Even if at the end of this video you think to yourself, accounting sucks, I want nothing to do with it, I'm gonna go study my general business degree, or I'm gonna go study my philosophy degree. That was almost me. Pick a career path that is going to compound over time. We've all heard of the idea of compound interest. We know what compound interest is. I think compound interest applies outside of just the realm of your bank account or your investments. Compound interest also applies to your career. Choose a career that over time, your income, your earning potential is going to compound. Sure, at the beginning, maybe you're making 40, 50, 60, and then you get a raise and then you make 53, and then you make 57, and so on and so forth. But over time, those jumps are gonna become bigger if you choose the right career. So choose a career that uses compound interest to your advantage in a career sense. And I would also say, keep your eye out for careers that have high earning potentials. Accounting is one of them. There are many other high earning potential careers that are nothing like accounting. You could become a lawyer, a doctor. You could study software engineering. You could break out and just become a plumber and build an incredible plumbing business. And you'd probably make more in your first 10 years as a plumber as most average accountants would make in their first 10 years. But I hope you keep those two factors in mind when you're choosing your own degree. Even if you want nothing to do with accounting, I really believe that those factors can help frame your decision and set you up for success. As always, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate every single view and I love making these videos for you guys. If you have any questions at all about your own career choices or your degree, or just where you're at in life and maybe you're trying to make a pivot or a change, drop a comment down below. I answer every single comment and I'm very engaged with the community here. So feel free to just lay out where you're at and we'll have a chat. Also, if you're looking for some other videos to watch, check out these.